Las Vegas 大家知道它赌场嘛，然后很多这个声色场所这样子。哦，那这位先生呢，他叫 Tony Hsieh 哦，谢家华先生，他在那边成立了他的这个卖鞋的这个网络公司哦，叫做 Zappos 哦，但他们基本上就是完全颠覆过去大家可能你可能买衣服，是不会经过，就是说比较能够接受在网络上买衣服，可是关于买鞋这件事情，很多时候即便是鞋号相同，也不见得能够合脚，所以他完全颠覆这件事情，就是他整个服务方式实在太棒了，就是你甚至可以就是一次 order 个五六双鞋，那你可以试这五六双鞋，然后如果觉得不合脚，他们可能隔一天就马上有人来把鞋子收回去。哦，那他的事业经营的相当成功，那甚至呢，他非常为人所知的就是他不管创，他其实一直在创业，然后就把公司都卖掉。哦，那他最在意的事情就是说他经营的企业是不是一直维持了这个快乐文化这件事情。哦，那甚至他也出了一本书叫做是这个 Delivering Happiness 这本书。哦，然后前两个月呢，他甚至在他这个 Zappos 这家公司里面，他做了一个宣布，就是说从现在开始我要取消这个公司里面所有人的头衔。哦，你即便跟了我十几年了，哦，那如果你觉得因为取消头衔之后让你不能够执行你的专案的话，没关系，我这样会给你相当丰厚的这个资遣费。哦，那公司的股票照样会给你这样，哦，之类的。啊，那因为他觉得他只要创了一个业，然后最后发展到一个程度之后，他开始发现他过去那种强调着快乐文化的这种公司的这个工作的一种互动模式开始改变的时候，他就想要做改变了，相当特别的一个人。哦，所以呢，基于这样的想法，他就想要在那个Las Vegas downtown 这个地方去用这个创业的概念去打造一个城市。哦，所以他就在那边打造一个叫做 Container Park 这样的一个城市，基本上就是一堆货柜去堆砌出来的一些创业空间。哦，那里面也进驻了很多商家。哦，那这就是他整个区域的样貌。那整个案子呢，基本上都他自己掏腰包去开发的。看起来相当有创意，看起来相当有想法，然后他又是一个这么的这个重视企业文化的人，然后又有这样的人来经营一个来发展一个城市，绝对不会像是一般的开发商只是单纯是唯利是图吧。所以这样的开发案应该有机会让Las Vegas 走出一个除了观光、赌场、或者是这些情色的这些行业以外，有新 一些更多元的经济或产业生态被发展出来吧。好，哦，似乎最后失败了。哦，那其实是相当令人讶异的。那我想跟大家就分享这一段影片。哦，然后或许大家也来可以来想想看，说为什么他后来失败了。
I'm Frank Gruber, the CEO and co-founder of Tech Cocktail. This is our COO and co-founder,
Jen Consalvo. Hello, everyone.
Downtown Project is a project that was started by Tony Hsieh, the CEO of Zappos.
Downtown Project already has it gone from just a handful of people to, I think, now over 60 employees. So they're a pretty large group embarking on something that's really never been done at this scale by a private group. Tech Cocktail is a news and events organization focused on startups and entrepreneurs around the world. So we produce news stories every day. We do events all over the world.
Downtown Project, it's a $350 million project. 50 of it goes to startups. So there's the Vegas Tech Fund, which is investing in early stage startup companies and attracting them downtown. There's also a $50 million small business fund, which basically is creating businesses, you know, restaurants and dog parks and yoga studios. And then there's also a part of it that's going into real estate, so I think it's about $200 million. So we're here at the Learning Village, downtown Las Vegas. And what it is a series of different trailers that were constructed to create classroom space for educational programming. Just about every single night, you can come and see a speaker or come and take a course or maybe there's a meetup. It was the fastest way that you could create a place where people could convene regularly.
I'm Sarris Radford, I'm the founder of Caputo Communities. The Downtown Project is an incredible experiment. Everything I've been seeing with all the new businesses and all the new life out here is really impressive.
I like the whole thing that's going on here. It's really interesting, you know, everything is sort of baked in Silicon Valley. So it's nice to see a smaller community.
One of the big exciting new additions to Downtown Vegas is the Container Park. I think it has roughly 40 small businesses in it, so the actual shipping containers create the park itself, and they're filled with bars and restaurants and boutiques and even a barber shop. There's a stage where they have lots of music acts. One of the most interesting parts of it is this sort of Swiss Family Robinson style giant treehouse in the middle where kids can just play all day long. So it's a really great community space.
Work in Progress is a co-working space. It's a place where, you know, companies work out. They can actually get their own dedicated space, or they can just be a community member and come when they like. They're continually doing different types of classes and different types of mentoring programs. So it's become a hub for startups.
One of the most unique spaces here in downtown Vegas is called the Stitch Factory.
We are a fashion incubator. We support and curate local and emerging designers. We have a design studio space where they can come and co-work out of and have access to our cutting tables, our dress forms, and industrial machines.
So it's very educational, but it's also very functional. So people can actually go there and build things for their fashion startup. It's a great space. They've thrown a few good parties there. And I actually had my wedding dress created there. They did it from design through implementation. It's a really neat space. In addition to the startups, the most amazing thing is there's physical change every day. And in the past year, it has just grown at such an incredible pace.
It used to be like you'd stay in this one or two block radius, and now that radius is like six blocks or eight blocks. It's continuing to grow outside of that, so every few months gets pushed out a little bit more.
All these things keep you excited because startups, they're invisible. They can work from anywhere. They're not like brick and mortar. So having this physical change helps, I think, to keep an excitement in the air.
To be able to plug into something like that that's got different stakeholders from the community, including Downtown Project, has helped us have that voice and also a place to listen and hear what's going on around the rest of the community.
One of my favorite little mottos that's popped up around town is Downtown Makes You Smarter. That's kind of part of the ethos of Downtown Vegas. Any given night of the week, anything from music to a speaker series to a trivia night, the things that you might expect going on across a huge city are all happening right here within the footprint.
就对于一个这么强调这个快乐文化，然后用一个感觉是非常的来自很像是刚刚提到那个矽谷那种创业文化，用这个甚至我们他们给他一个名字叫做 Startup Urbanism， 这个创业的一个都市主义，用这样的方式来翻转一个旧街区哦，旧市中心的区域，到底是哪里出错哦？我的看法是哦，我觉得大家其实对于 Las Vegas 已经有一个非常强烈的一个识别性，就刚刚从一开始谈到这个城市要有它的识别性，大家想到 Las Vegas， 想到它的赌场，想到它就是纯粹在 service 这个外来的观光客，大家都去那边，很像暂时逃离一个高压的都市生活，去那边就是这个一夜千金啊，就是去赌博，然后可以让你的感官上面尽情的这个享受哦。那到底 Las Vegas 有没有其他的需求？哦，那我觉得很有可能是，就刚那一群这个接受访问的人哦，他们其实都是多数都不是当地的人，他们都是Tony Hsieh从这个旧金山找来这边创业的人，所以似乎他们其实是把他们原本在旧金山非常 enjoy 的一种生活方式搬来这边，然后在这边就想说，我来这边来创一个我在那边原本在旧金山就喜欢的生活方式。所以他们在这个 Container Park 里面就创造了一个其实是听起来是相当创新，听起来相当有趣，而基本上是一个相对封闭的一个生态系。这生态系只是 for 他们这些人会去欣赏，然 然后对他们而言是 有意思的空间或有意思 的事业，对于当地人是没有任何帮助的，或者是当地人也不会想要来这边消费，因为对他们跟他们生活没有任何连结。然后另外一件事情就是说，他有没有可能在这个招商或者进驻的条件里面，对于进驻的这些新的创业家来讲，是那个条件是相对来讲是用这种矽谷创业那种条件，可能你几年之内就要 IPO， 或者是那个整个对于你的那个成长 的速度是要求的相当快的。所以就是延续着刚刚讲的，就是他就在地就没有这些需求，所以他事业自然成长不起来，所以更别说达到他所要求的那一种这种成长 的速度跟规模，所以让他们这些进驻的创业家来讲的话，相对承受相当大的压力，所以另外一件事情是说，其实你在经营一座城市，不是所有东西都可以被衡量的，那他可如果是譬如说你需要一个时间去酝酿一个城市的一种风格或一种文化，那这东西是可以像用创业的这种整个 IPO 的相对这种有的这种知识的这种可以量化的这些条件去审视的吗？或许是没有办法的，所以这就是他为什么后来，就我的看法，为什么他后来失败了，然后其实他现在里面就蛮多的这种scandal， 就是这个丑闻，所以这是对于这个长期以来标榜快乐文化通力学来讲的话，是一个算是一个很大的一个 setback 这样子。那总之呢，今天的案例先跟大家分享到这里。我觉得就是很重要的地方是说，其实我回来台湾之后发现，就像是这个地方，其实很多人都在不同的地方做很多很有意义的事情，可是我都会希望说，这些新的精神或新的能量、新的事业的经营的方式或新的产业，是有机会去向外扩散，去影响整个街区的发展。那甚至说像这样，其实因为我现在在帮一些中南部的一些县市做一些城市策略的案子，那我也看到很多年轻人都愿意返乡去做一些创业的事情这样。可是很多时候一个平台或是一个生态系的建立的一个愿景是很重要的，那创意应该是要落实在很多地方，那创意更应该要落实在你经营事业的一个 business model， 那甚至因为这个生态系被建立起来之后，它所带动了整个产业链的上下游的这个串联，让每一个城市都能够有自己的一个 position， 一个定位被带动出来，啊，每一个城市它应该都有机会走出一个很不一样的一种生活风格，让你去那边生活，其实很多时候不单单只是为了赚钱，你每个人都有他生活要追求的一种很独特的价值观，不是每个人都想要去大都市里面，然后就是人挤人去密度很高的地方追求很快速的一种致富的一个模式，所以这是我今天整个讲座下来希望能够传递的一个讯息，谢谢大家。